And new at 4, it has certainly been a challenging year for schools already, and now Mobile County Public School students will start to transition back into the classroom. And this month, our investigative reporter Brendan Kirby is standing by live with a preview of exactly how that will work. Hi, Brendan.
Hi, Lanise. E.R. Dixon Elementary School was empty of children today, but class was in session just as it has been all month long. Classroom teachers were instructing their remote learners through the Schoology program. Some students at home even were participating in physical education classes conducted live in an empty classroom. It's been an adjustment, and teachers and students soon will have to adapt again. Alabama's largest school system deciding yesterday that it will allow students to begin returning weeks earlier than originally scheduled. It will be up to each family to decide whether it wants children to go back in person or keep learning at home. School system officials are contacting families now to see what they want to do. E.R. Dixon Principal Katrina Kinn says she expects 75% to 80% of her 900 students will decide to go back to the classroom. She acknowledges that won't be easy, especially for the pre-kindergarten and kindergarten students who will be among the first to return on September 14th.
The expectations are for us to get our students in our school and to get them in safely and to get them reacclimated to being in school. They have not been in school since March, so it's going to be a process of helping them to get back into our school rules, our procedures, and we're going to explain the expectations of learning.
Once in the school building, students will be expected to wear uniforms and masks. School system spokeswoman Renee Phillips says students will continue much as they were when they were learning remotely using the Schoology program on their laptops.
So we will continue to use Schoology, so that'll make it more of a seamless transition as the students come back. And that way the students who are learning remotely can get the same exact classroom instruction as they're getting at school. The difference is if you're in school, you'll have time between the live lessons that you can interact with your teacher.
Phillips says administrators will give families some flexibility. If they change their minds, they'll be able to switch their kids to either remote learning or in-person instruction. But she says students won't be allowed to go to the classroom on some days and stay home on others. Reporting live for Fox 10 News, this is Brendan Kirby.